name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today, dear brothers and sisters, the Mother Church celebrates Saint Albert the Great, Bishop, Confessor, and Doctor of the Church. Saint Albert was really a great man. This name was given to him because he was a genius of theology, philosophy, but also a scientist. He had an interest in all disciplines and sciences, especially natural sciences. Saint Albert was a Dominican friar. We are in the 13th century, and as you know, the Dominicans are very well into preaching and studying. Saint Dominic gave to his order this special mission to be always ready to fight against the errors, the heresies. In order to fight against the heresies, the preachers have to know very well the doctrine and the foundation of the doctrine, especially philosophy. Saint Albert followed this example of his founder and father, Saint Dominic, and wanted to be ready to always give an answer to everyone, especially by bringing all the knowledge together. His effort was even to write a treatise by bringing all disciplines, all knowledge together, and showing the unity of knowledge, whose foundation, whose last root is the truth. The truth is God. This is an important effort, especially in our, for our days, when we are very ready to split faith from science, supernatural realities from natural events. We are following some very secularized thoughts, are very keen on saying that we can believe in God, but believing is something concerning my faith, something mysterious but hidden in my heart, and living and investigating this world is something else. Sciences do something different, to the point that you can even deny God's existence with science. And it doesn't matter, because you can still believe in God if you have your faith. This is a kind of contradiction, but we live in this contradiction, and we accept this contradiction, that science can deny God, and it is possible, but you can still believe in God with your faith. What's the point to believe in God when the life and the knowledge, natural knowledge, is blind, is not able to see God? This is not possible. It is not true, because science and faith, science and theology, though distinct disciplines, they investigate the truth, they investigate reality, and in the end, they both come to converge, because reality is made by the same author. The reality is the truth, and the truth is one, because the author of truth is one. The author is God. Though the levels are distinct, the levels of investigation are distinct, and each one has its own law to follow, but the truth is one, natural and supernatural. Natural, preparing the possibility for the supernatural truth to be revealed. With Galileo Galilei, we could also say there is a book. There are two books, basically, necessary to know. One is natural, and this is the book of creation. Another one is supernatural, and this is the Bible. There is no contradiction between the book of creation and the book of revelation, the Bible. Saint Albert the Great is showing this profound unity between faith and science in this double book, but one truth. Among his students, when he was teaching in Paris and Cologne, there was a great man, another great man, Saint Thomas Aquinas. This is, we know today more Saint Thomas than Saint Albert the Great, but behind a great saint, a great scholar, there is always a great teacher. So we pray today to Saint Albert the Great to regain this wisdom, the wisdom to see all the whole knowledge as one possible way to come to know what is truly important, the truth and the salvific truth. The truth starting with our life, the laws regulating the phenomena, this life, and the truth leading us to eternal salvation. One truth, one God, one Christ. Saint Albert became also Bishop of Ratisbon and died in 1280, was canonized and declared Doctor of the Church in 1931 by Pius XI. He's also a Doctor of the Church. We pray Saint Albert also for all scientists, that they may accept the truth about themselves and can come to know the whole truth, God, and may find the faith, which is the answer to everything, bringing everything together, as Saint Albert the Great did. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.